Probably have a favorite candy bar. There are so many options. But did you know one of the most popular candy bars of all time was created in Minneapolis? Joe Mazin has a look at this tasty treat in this week's So Minnesota.
In the North Loop of Minneapolis, few who pass this building on Washington Avenue know of its sweet history.
Everything's for real in bars from Mars.
If the walls could talk, they would tell you about rich chocolate, creamy caramel, and smooth nougat.
It's the one of a kind.
The building is the birthplace of the Milky Way candy bar.
Chocolate, chewy caramel, luscious nougat.
Many people are really surprised when they hear that Minnesota connection, and it actually started here.
Historian Kathleen Kullberg knows about the man behind the bar of sugary goodness.
He actually was born in Minnesota, western Minnesota, with his family.
Franklin Mars was born in Hancock, Minnesota. His mother taught him a love for chocolates.
He had gotten an early mild case of polio, and so he couldn't do the normal things that people would do on the farm or in business. And so he worked with his mother in the kitchen. And she, I guess, was a good candy maker because she started teaching him how to make candy, not bread, but candy.
After several setbacks in the early 1920s, Mars opened a candy company in Minneapolis. One day while at an ice cream parlor, his son Forrest made a suggestion of creating a new candy bar that tasted like a chocolate malt shake.
And just happened to say, why don't you add malted milk to it? It's popular, everybody likes it, it has a great flavor. And he didn't think his dad would take him seriously. But Franklin went back to his factory and he started playing with that and he came up with this malted milk confection.
They named it the Milky Way Bar. It was an instant and huge success. It would bring the family fame and fortune.
The best candy on earth.
Even Franklin Mars' home on West Minnehaha Parkway in Minneapolis took on a sweet nickname.
They call that the Milky Way House.
By 1929, with the success of the Milky Way, Franklin Mars moved the company to Chicago. They would go on to create other candy classics, including Snickers, M&M's, Three Musketeers, and Twix. Franklin Mars died of heart problems in 1934 at the age of 50. He's buried at Lakewood Cemetery in Minneapolis. His son, Forrest, took over the family business. The Mars family still runs the company to this day. The combined fortune of the family is estimated at around $126 billion, making them one of the richest families in the world.
Brett Gertz.
Sorry, I was eating a Milky Way.
If you're looking for an American success story, you'll find it in Franklin Mars.
You have that dream, and where there's a will, there's a way. And even though he was bankrupt several times, maybe it made him a stronger person because of having some adversities that he had to overcome. It made the company stronger.
At Mars' former factory, there's a small plaque giving the history as the birthplace of the Milky Way bar. Here, a Minnesotan left a mark on the world's sweet tooth. In Minneapolis, Joe Mazin, 5 Eyewitness News.